The state DOT has 17 harbor enforcement officers, and they mainly patrol Honolulu Harbor and Kalailoa Barbers Point Harbor. They also work with the Coast Guard and Customs and Border Patrol when needed. Senator Willis Sparrow introduced Senate Bill 2589 after several harbor police officers came to him asking for help.
And the feeling is that they want this change and they want to be a part of Department of Public Safety.
And why should the public care about this?
Well, at this stage, this is the best thing to do for the harbor police. Over the years, they have had morale problems, leadership issues, poor management is what I've been hearing from people who are currently working at the Harbor Police, and their standards and their training level is not at par with the deputy sheriffs.
According to the DOT, all harbor enforcement recruits receive about 3 months of classroom training compared to 6 months for deputy sheriffs. But the DOT says about half of the harbor police officers have passed either the Honolulu Police Academy or the Sheriff's Division Training Academy. Esparo says the bill aims to bring the rest of the officers up to speed.
What we want to do is incorporate them with the deputy sheriffs, make them better, and improve the whole law enforcement aspect along the harbor.
During the legislative hearings, both the DOT and DPS testified in support of the bill. But now the DOT has a new person in charge of the department. The governor's press secretary won't say why the governor intends to veto the bill, and that we'll have to wait till next month when any bill on the veto list will include a statement of objectives, which will clearly outline the administration's position.
This is something that I hope the governor will certainly look at closely before he makes his decision.
The DPS says whatever happens, the DPS will work with the DOT Harbors Division to provide training and other support to ensure that law enforcement activities are carried out based on accepted standards and policies.